It's Turbulent Thursday. That's right. Oftentimes, that's exactly what happens. As we come up to, just getting past the hump day of Wednesday, and hopefully Friday is a little calmer, gives us a chance maybe to take off a little bit early as the weather gets warmer and enjoy the weekend. But then we have to get through Thursday, Turbulent Thursday. Well, I'd like to talk to you a little bit about some of the things that might make it a little less turbulent, maybe life a little bit easier, maybe a little bit more fun. And, you know, if you do it right, it could make you a little bit more money, perhaps give you a lot more business, and perhaps do what Walmart does. That's right. You and Walmart could have something in common. And let me tell you what all of that might mean as we do. Y-O-R-S. Y-O-R-S. Let's see what that means. I'm Stan Hughes, and the program is Interesting Ideas, brought to you by What It Takes Radio. And this program is for you, and it's starting right now. I often encourage clients of mine, particularly in my coaching business, which I was kind of transitioning mostly from coaching into radio, and I am doing that. I don't have to be on airplanes nearly as much, but I'm finding that more and more my coaching services are coming back, and they're quite helpful in many ways. And of course, now, of course, I'm going to be doing more and more of my coaching on the radio, which means that I will not have to do all of that wonderful, you know, going through security, going through the airplanes, getting off the airplanes, getting there 2 hours before departure time. Yeah, as I often say with a smile, I'm so old that I remember when flying was fun. Hey, here we go. YORS. Your own radio station. Now, basically, that's what I help people do. And more people, as even one of my good friends in broadcasting has said, more and more people are listening to the radio. Unfortunately, they aren't listening to us. Now, what he was talking about was that he was a proprietor of a major traditional, as we say, towers and transmitters radio station, the radio station that most of us, if we still listen to the radio, listen to, the one that most often we listen to in the car. However, we may listen to it at work if they'll allow us to do that, but if we just don't usually anymore, just sit down as they used to and turn on the radio and listen to the radio. In fact, many people have suggested, and of course the radio industry knows this, why do you think they are fighting so hard to make sure that all of the new cars still have an AM radio band in them? Because you see, the radio people who make radios and sell them to the cars, they say, hey, that just takes up space that a lot of people never listen to. You should have maybe an FM radio, but of course what you really want is subscription radio, and you want something that is in a internet configuration so people can listen to their own podcast that they want. And not only their own podcast, because they do one themselves, but they can listen to other people's podcasts. And the amount of podcasting is growing slowly now, but it is growing. And interestingly enough, it is growing in the 55 and up category. You know, people like me. And the reason perhaps is, again, the same reasons, you can listen to it anywhere, anytime you want, personal, on demand. You don't have to, you know, tune in and hopefully have the program or the music you want. You can just choose it yourself. But at the same time, the traditional radio stations are oftentimes not having the kind of programming that, you know, people want, because the over 50 crowd is not in the buying demographic that oftentimes most advertisers, oftentimes mistakenly, are looking for. So having your own radio station, YORS, might be a possibility. Let me give you just a few thoughts on this turbulent Thursday that will get you thinking. Times are turbulent. Someone once said to me, don't worry, things are going to get worse before they get worse. And there are a lot of people right now who are, as they look at the economic, the political, the social, the relational, certainly the threat of war, have said, you know, we could be in for some really bad times. This might be a challenging time to be alive. And most of us were not expecting that at this stage in our lives and at this stage in our history that things were going to be quite so difficult. And now the prospect that they might even get worse as prices go up and sometimes opportunities go down and the world as we know it. And as I often say, and I've had people, you know, in the prayers we do at churches, dear God, be with the people whose life is not what they want it to be right now. Dear God, be with the people whose life is not what they want it to be right now. And that may include you. On occasion, it sometimes includes me, but that is more and more the case. And the rise in suicides, alcoholism, depression, all of the social ills that we seemingly are finding more and more prevalent in our world. This is a challenging time. And it would be good if we could look out and say, is there somebody or is there something or some idea that could come forward and at least reduce the pain, increase the gain, and perhaps give us a sense that things truly could be, would be, might be, and maybe even should be better. Just a little bit right now. Well, that's just a thought and a prayer and a wish as we go through Thursday. Mother's Day is before us, so you will hopefully celebrate that. Though, as I oftentimes reminded people, and this was always the case, and of course you now see it in some advertising, where when a company or a product is offering Mother's Day gifts or Mother's Day celebration type gifts, that you can, they go down and you say, if you would rather not receive any commercials or promotions or advertisements about Mother's Day, click here. And I remember that because a number of years ago, our church was going through the usual Mother's Day celebration. And I just had to remind the pastor, I said, you know, for a number of women, this might not be a happy day. Oh, it's Mother's Day. They had a mother. Or they are a mother. I said, and they might have wanted to be a mother, and now they're not. Or they can't be. Or they may be a mother, and they remember they lost a child. Or they may have had a very mean and wicked stepmother. You know, the whole deal. I said, please be aware that whenever you do those kinds of celebrations, which of course, you know, as someone said, it's a Hallmark day, you know, that there are some people, perhaps a goodly number of people, who simply can't join in the usual celebrations because of their situation, their circumstance. And now I have found that, at least in some of the churches and some of the organizations, they're being a little more careful about that and even giving some acknowledgement to the fact that Mother's Day for many, or certainly for some, perhaps is not that good or nice of a day. But if you are going to, and you're going to make it a celebration day, and you have every right to do that, and you know that you're not hurting anybody or making anybody else sad, certainly do that. I just talked to a colleague, and she said, and I said, how's your weekend? And then she smiled and said, I am a good Irish Catholic mother. And I am going to celebrate. My whole weekend is beautifully planned. You know what? Good for her. And good for you. Here we go. More and more, you're going to have to know that in your life and business, more and more people are going to go to situations where they will get the news or the information that is more relevant to them or delivered by people more connected to them. And that's the business I'm in. For instance, every business should think about having their own radio station. Now, many of you listen to a company radio station. I know you do. You may not know it, but you walk into the Walmart and they're playing music. Oh, no. They are not playing music from the radio. They are creating the music. Walmart has a radio station. And of course, it is the station that is on in all of the Walmart stores. And so not only does it, and they have disc jockeys, they have entertainment, they have music, they have all of that good happy talk. And of course, they just happen to what? By the way, you know, this is on sale at Walmart. Well, that's easy to do. Walmart has their own radio station. Now, I know that, but they may have several, you know. They might even target it to different parts of the country, which they would do if they were smart or smarter. They probably do. And they would make sure that it created the kinds of scenes and the kinds of music, and it would be very strongly tested to make sure that it was mostly wholesome with a little bit of an edge, maybe a little bit of country, and it might even throw in a touch of gospel from time to time, something like that. It would be something that would pleasantly please most people and probably not truly offend hardly anybody. There are companies now that have done away with the inter-office company memo, you know, the thing you get from headquarters or corporate or the district manager that lands up in your email box, which, of course, for the most part, you don't read unless, of course, you know that you might be quizzed on it. And so you have to indicate that you did read it. Okay. But what they're finding is, if you're going to share information, if it's heard with a pleasant voice, if it's heard with a smile, things, if they have a touch of entertainment to them, have a greater chance of being paid attention to, listened to, and from that, people might even pay attention and learn something. In fact, they might even do something. And they might even do something that is good for them, for the company, for you, for the world. Here we go. I'm at 15 minutes, and my time is up on Thursday, but I'm just going to simply say your company, your church, your place of worship, your synagogue, your business, perhaps even the people who are working for you around the world, you need to have a way for you to tell the story, hear their story, share good news, enjoy good music, keep up to date, and perhaps bring a smile and a delight from time to time. Your company needs its own radio station. and it's very easy to do. And perhaps you need your own radio station too. I do, and I can help you do the same thing. Reach out to me at stanhusted@gmail.com, stanhusted@gmail.com. I have a number of those, but Gmail is the easiest to remember, stanhusted@gmail.com. WITRadio.net will introduce you to podcasting, which simply means you can have your own radio station. All the best and blessings. Take care through the weekend. By the way, we will be back tomorrow with a little more technical. Now, if you're smart, you want to really figure some things out. On our transformation podcast, we're going to talk a little bit about how you can actually get people to pay attention and do something. How to help them transform themselves, perhaps their organization, their communities. How to change, and maybe change big time. We'll see if we can play with that subject tomorrow. Again, all the best and blessings, and I really mean that. Always close with a benediction. Say a good word for all. Till next time, bye for now.